This video shows how device diagnostics are incorporated in daily work practices from a control system operator console. In this video, you will learn how device diagnostics help operators, how to integrate device diagnostics in daily work practices, how EDDL integrates devices diagnostics into operator console, how EDDL integrates different protocols into the same system. Let's first look at a foundation Filbus PH transmitter. This is the operator console display in normal operation. There are no alarms in the alarm banner at the bottom of the screen. The control system captures diagnostics alerts from Filbus devices in the system. When a device failure is detected by device self-diagnostics and reported across the Filbus, it automatically appears as a device alert in the alarm banner in the bottom of the screen. There is no question of which device is having a problem. The device tells you. You don't have to spend time searching on a hunch. The operator clicks on the device alert in the alarm banner, which opens the device faceplate. The pH value looks like a normal 6.9. But the faceplate makes clear that there is a serious device failure and that it is due to a broken pH glass electrode. Without device diagnostics, the error would go undetected for long periods because a pH near 7 is neutral and good. As a first course of action, the operator may, for instance, put the loop in manual or take any other steps before the process is affected. The operator may have minutes or hours to respond. Once the process has been taken care of, the operator can, at a simple click on the asset management button, launch the intelligent device management software right in the operator station. There is no need for the technician to move to another maintenance computer, log in and search for the tag. The operator follows the red tabs to see the details of the failure. The content and structure of the diagnostics display is completely controlled by the device manufacturer using EDDL, not the system manufacturer. For guidance, the operator clicks on the help button and next on the failure indication. Help text for the failure appears. The help text is provided through the EDDL file by the device manufacturer's expert who knows the product best. Actionable information guides the user towards the appropriate action. The operator cannot fix the problem sitting at a console, but can radio a technician in the field with the details enabling the problem to be fixed quickly. Note that the operator can only see device diagnostics. There is no configuration bar setup tab in the operator display, so the operator cannot make changes to the device. Next, let's look at a foundation Filbus temperature transmitter in a different scenario. The device alert appears and the operator clicks on the alarm banner, which opens the device faceplate. In this case, the faceplate shows it is a less serious maintenance diagnostics error. The operator opens detailed diagnostics at a click of a button without switching to another computer or software and without searching for the tag. The operator sees the device is actually still in good health, so operator need not put the control loop in manual. Control continues as usual. The operator follows the red tabs to see the detail of the error. The detailed diagnostics reveals first that sensor number 1 is broken, but also that the transmitter's hot backup function is activated. That is, the transmitter has switched to a second redundant sensor and is therefore still able to measure, enabling control to continue. Conditional images illustrates that the problem is related to the sensor or the wiring. The operator cannot fix the problem, but can call on a maintenance technician to do the repair. Had the operator not received this alert and called on the technician, it is unlikely the technician would get to know about the failed sensor anytime soon, since the technician is busy in the field and may not log in to the maintenance computer very often. Once the problem is fixed, the diagnostics indicator and conditional image automatically change to show the device is okay. It is up to plant alarm management philosophy if a non-critical maintenance warning, in this example not affecting the process, shall be enunciated on operator stations, or if only critical failures, as in the previous example, affecting the process shall be alerted to operators. Now, let's look at a hot protocol temperature transmitter in a safety instrumented system. The system is continuously monitoring the health of all hot devices. The device alert appears and the operator clicks on the alarm banner, which opens the device faceplate. In this case, the faceplate shows it is a serious device failure, not a process problem. Without device diagnostics, the failure would masquerade as a process problem and likely trip the shutdown valve. The operator opens detailed diagnostics at a click of a button. The diagnostics page is designed by the device manufacturer using EDDL opens. The operator follows the red tabs to see the details of the failure. In this case, it is a sensor failure. In this last example, let's look at a wireless heart temperature transmitter. The system is continuously monitoring the health of all wireless heart devices. The device alert appears and the operator clicks on the alarm banner, which opens the device faceplate. In this case, the faceplate shows it is a serious device failure. The operator opens detailed diagnostics at a click of a button. The detailed diagnostics is displayed, rendered by the system as intended by the device manufacturer based on the EDDL file. For guidance, the operator clicks on the help button and next the failure indication. Manufacturer's help is displayed. If diagnostics is not integrated into the operator consoles, where operators can see it and use it to act before the process is affected, chances are that diagnostics will not become a natural part of daily work practices. Diagnostics only displayed on a maintenance station, not continuously manned, will not be seen in time to make a difference. The device diagnostics and device management system may fall into disuse. Device alerts can be prioritized based on the criticality of the device to the process and the severity of the fault. Only critical alerts are enunciated on operator stations so as to not flood operators with alarms. All diagnostic is logged in the maintenance station. A technician at a maintenance console can see the same diagnostics and can also perform other device management functions such as device configuration and calibration. Integrated diagnostics is possible with EDDL because EDDL is not driver software, just compressed text. Other solutions use driver programs not permitted on control system, therefore only displaying diagnostics on separate maintenance stations. That is, integrate smart diagnostics can only be done using EDDL. You have seen how device diagnostics is an early warning that help operators care for the process. How to incorporate diagnostics in predictive maintenance. How device diagnostics can be displayed to the right people. How devices with three different protocols, Foundation Fieldbus, Heart and Wireless Heart, appear the same basic way because EDDL is an integral part of all three protocols. Use EDDL to effectively incorporate diagnostics into daily work practices. Visit www.eddl.org for more information.